important because if we know more about what happened in the past, it can help us progress in the future and keep us from repeating things that weren't so good and help us expand on things that were fantastic.
Rural traditions, community connections, we've got those things here in spades.
These people who lived here prior to us set the community at a stage for us now.
Rural traditions, community connections.
The good part of these were found in my brother's garden, actually Red Hook here. Some of them are thousands of years old.
We people of Red Hook have got it made.
I got interested in history because of the old tools. Even the castings are decorative. No, you don't get that nowadays.
The sport of ice boating has been very popular on the Hudson River for about 150 years. Many of the occupations of the river, including farming and the transportation on the river, kind of came to a halt as a result of the winter and the ice. So many people turned to the great pleasure of sailing upon the river.
I love the history of Red Hook because there's so much to learn and new things just pop up right in front of you.
The best way to get children hooked on history is to use authentic experiences very similar to what this is.
It's like an open-air museum. You can study it, you can get underneath it, around it, see how it's constructed.
It's all a mighty cool way to keep those connections alive today.
I really enjoyed working with enthusiastic 21st century children in the 1912 classroom.
My favorite part was the schoolhouse.
They really enjoyed learning that they saluted the flag in 1912 during the pledge instead of covering their heart as they do today.
Rural traditions, community connections, we've got those things here in space.
I'd like to learn about the games the kids played a long time ago.
It's important for our children to understand what's happening then and now so we don't lose this.
My favorite game was trying to catch the ball in the cup.
What I geared this whole event to was young people.
One of our goals is to get kids more involved in agriculture and farming.
We get new farmers by inspiring our youth, by supporting them.
There is this chicken that's really fluffy, it's white.
One of the best ways to get more kids involved in agriculture would be to provide horticultural experiences in schools.
Just like Native American Indians were the first people to live here, this is a native plant.
And right here at our school, we're growing lots of good food too.
There are a few things in this world more important than knowing where you're going to get your healthy food to sustain your community.
When apples come out and they're just amazing, that's a definition of the community. This is a Red Hook apple.
Apples for me, apples for you.
It's a great pride.
Apple cider, apple sauce, Red Hook is the apple boss. Rural tradition.
I was taking my grandchildren around today, showing them all the things I remember from Red Hook.
Community connections.
I was telling them about the old railway. I used to go through the Huckabush.
We've got those things here in space.
We teach the kids the benefits of fiber, what to do with it, and why these animals were brought to the country hundreds of years ago.
Thanks to Bonaparte sheep, our wool production was hard to beat.
I'm actually interested in the whole process. Growing the actual flax would be wonderful, and learning to weave it and learning to sew something from it. That's my ultimate goal.
Weaving the local wool, the women had lots of work to do. 16,000 yards of cloth, their hard work certainly paid off. Rural traditions, community connections. We people of Red Hook have got it made. We people of Red Hook have got it made.
I think 100 years from now, there will be a lot more kids living in Red Hook.
I think Red Hook is going to look very similar to what it looks like today, in that there's been some really smart land use and regulations and ordinances put in place.
I hope that it's doing as well as it is now.
We've protected the farmlands well, so we're not going to get the mass development that you see in places like Hyde Park.
Tivoli and Red Hook have become very dear to me because they're preserving something that I think was too easily let go in other parts of the country.
I'm hoping that it has some more of the eco-friendly elements that we've been adding over the years.
I'd love to see all the buildings, all the older buildings, being preserved.
Red Hook was the breadbasket going way back, even to the 18th century, well, actually 17th century. And it was because you had some growing populations in New York City and Albany, and we still can be that breadbasket. We still have that rural ambiance about this village and this town. So the fact that the people of this rural area want to keep it rural fits with the way I want to live too. And if we pass that down to our children and our grandchildren, then we might be able to perpetuate this before it becomes an urban satellite and out of hand and never will change back. Will history really attract people or not? The only way to find out is give it a shot and see if, in fact, you can attract the general public. The proof is we did.
Fun things to do.